Hey, what's happening everybody? Dano here. I'm gonna finally get to building this thing out with this new cradle system I got. I got this stuff a few months ago back during the holidays, and I'm just now getting around to doing this. This is the Astrodymium ring system with ZWO EAF mount for a Samyang Rokinon 135 F2 lens. I don't know if it's pronounced Astrodymium or Astrodymium, but they're out of Canada, and it's a 3D printed cradle system for this thing. Now, my last video, the review of this lens, this is how I currently had it built out with the William Optics Red Cat ring holder and a dovetail bar. And this has been working fine, but I wanted to put a focuser on this thing. And also this ring system, this cradle system, should also help with the balance. And I'll have all this sorted out to where it's nice and level and a little bit lower profile. I had this out just to show that this is one way of mounting it with a, if you're using a dedicated camera. If you're using a DSLR, this wouldn't work, but you could also use one of these camera mounts and put it on a dovetail and then apply one of the little finder deals on the ring. This lens is really heavy, and so that I feel like that puts a little bit of a strain. This is the first way I was gonna do it, but I feel like that puts a little bit too much strain with the weight of this lens. So this, and this is okay here too. This is a 1-point system with this William Optics ring, but this is now going to be a 2-point system. So in today's video, I'm just going to go over finally putting this thing together and see if I can get this all sorted today. So follow along if you have a Rokinon 135 or you're thinking about getting one and you want to build it out into a little astrophotography rig for wide field. So I picked this up on a Gina Astro, and I think it was around $89. I just looked today, that's what it is, I think. There are several different options. This is the one with the EAF full cradle system, and then I also got an extra accessory rail. This will be to mount my ASI air. Let's just open this thing up and see what's inside. You can scan this QR code and it'll take you to the instruction manual, which I should probably be doing. And I may do this and then come back and install it. But we'll just take everything out of the box here. We have some paper. So here is a some kind of ring. I don't know what that's for, but we'll find out. Here is, this looks like that's gonna be the electronic autofocuser mount right there, the mounting bracket. And we have a bag with the focuser belt and a bunch of screws. And then we have the cradle. And you'll see one is larger, and that's gonna go on the front side of the lens, and then the smaller will go on the backside closer to the camera. And it comes with this rail, and I have this second rail I'm going to install on here, so it'll be three sides. So that's it. That's all the parts. Looks like Bill out of Canada got a little note in here saying thanks for the purchase. So that's everything in the box right here. Let's get to putting this thing together. Okay, so here comes the fun part. I'm gonna dump this out. Whee! All right, that's it. So these little square adapter pieces here, you're gonna have two sizes. I think it said it was an M6. Let's see, M6, you have two of those, the larger ones, and M5, you have six pieces. The M6 will go on the, let's see if you can get some light here. The M6 will go on the attachment to the bottom of the cradle, and the smaller ones will go on the top here. And same for this piece. The big one here, the three small ones here. Okay, looks like these are gonna be the hinge screws for the cradle. I'm not sure exactly what the rest of these screws are yet. I'm going to find out as we go along. This is the belt for the focuser, and this looks like the attachment for the focuser. I'm using a multi-tool because there was no Allen keys that came with it. So I've got a Allen key multi-tool here, and this is a focus. This goes to the focus wheel, the belt. And these are the screws for the cradle. These are for accessories. And these are for attachment. So the first step we're going to do is take these out and go ahead and push these into the slots here and install them. I'm going to take the three small ones and just push them in. Now I'll go back with this little thumb screw here and just make sure that the holes are flush here. Let's get this last one popped in, and I just push right in there, and then we'll just take the little screw here and let's see if we can see that hole line up. All right, that's it. Now we're going to install this saddle piece here, and or the accessory rail, and I'm going to make sure I have these set up right. I think I'm going to open the cradle to the right here, so you want to look at your two pieces. This is the bigger piece. This is going to go on the edge of the lens, and this is going to go on the back of the lens. So I'm going to set it up like this, and I'm going to set the rail. And here's the thing, I don't know if I don't want these the thumb screw holes to be in the way of the focuser or the ASIR, so I'm not sure which way to put it, but for now I'm just going to put it on the left side, but the cradle's actually going to open on the right side. But you're going to have these three screws here, and they use a 3mm hex head, and I'm just going to go ahead and put this on real quick. Make sure that we have the cradle opening on the same side, like that, and go ahead and attach this one. Since it's plastic and not metal, I'm not gonna, you know, really crank down on it until I get it everything set up right. But now we're starting to look like a cradle here. I'm gonna go ahead and add this other accessory rail. In the instructions, it was showing a way to mount the ASIR to it, but I think that could have been an older version. This says only compatible with version 4.0 or higher. I think this is version 6 of this ring system here, but this is what I wanted to see, if these thumb screws right here are going to, like, if once I put this rail on and there's an ASIR, I'm not going to be able to access those screws, I'm thinking. So I may have to flip the top one around, but about to find that out now. One thing I'll add about the second rail is you definitely want the thumb screws on the bottom here, so you'll be able to access them. If they're turned up here, may not be able to reach them. So that's probably what I'm going to do, is flip this one around and make sure that this one is like this, where the thumb hole screws are on the bottom. I'm just going to turn this thing on the side and make sure that the thumb hole screws are facing to my left here, and just go ahead and drop these screws that came with it in. Now, if there's a different version, may have some other kind of plate where you can screw the ASIR on directly to the cradle, but I don't see that part. But I wanted this rail so I can share an ASIR with a different scope, like if I want to take it off of here and put it on my other scope. So this is why I wanted the rail. So I made a couple adjustments here. I flipped the one on the top around, so the thumb screws are over here on the right side, because I went ahead and reconfigured my ASIR to where it's back to a low profile position with the little shoe on the bottom. And I made sure these are closer to the camera side, because I want this a little closer for now, but I can adjust that easy. But when I slide the ASI air in, and I go ahead and tighten it down. The screws were over here. The thumb screws for this plate were over here. Now you can reach them just fine, but I'm going to have cables coming out of these 12 volt ports, so it was kind of close to where I could probably get by just using 1 and 2 and have room to adjust those. But I just flipped it around to that side. I'm going to put the gyroscope up here. The focuser goes over here, so hopefully this won't be in the way. But as of now, that's how I've got it configured. I just flipped the plate around to where the thumb screw is on the right side, along with how the cradle opens up. I'm using the William Optics dovetail. This is a pretty big one, and I could probably use a smaller one, but I'm just going to go ahead and use this one anyways. And I was looking at it, and I think I am going to center this thing and just go with that for now. I'm going to use the bolts that I had, but the cradle system does come with two. So this uses a 5mm hex head wrench, and I'm just going to go ahead and try to seat this in here. And that's centered on the dovetail, and we'll see how this works. The camera's going to stick out probably close to the end, and I'll have a little bit of room for balancing if I use this on, well, I'll be using it with the GTI, but I'd like to try it with the AM5 as well. May not be heavy enough, but we'll see. Okay, I've loosened the top rail, also the bottom dovetail screws, because every time I tighten it down, this top kind of comes over a little bit and it's not flush. After messing with this for a few minutes, when I attach this to the dovetail, it seems to kind of want to twist a little bit. Now they still line up, but I'd like to have it flush. So what you have to do is just loosen it. I don't know if you can see that, but it's flush right there. But when I tighten it, the bottom piece kind of goes to the right a little bit. So what you'll have to do maybe is see which way it's pulling. So the bottom is going to the right. So I'm going to push back on that to the left. And when I tighten it up, it should be, it's a little more flush. So this should go in here no problem. And I'm not going to crank it too much, but just make sure that's nice and snug. Yep. All right. So I thought that this dovetail is so close to the edge right here on the fit. I went and got my Ascar, my extra one, and took my camera ring off of that, and I tried it on there, and it was doing the same thing. So I'm just going to stick with this one I've been using. But that you may have to twist the bottom just to kind of keep those pieces flush, because when you bolt down on it, it seems it wants to twist it a little bit. But that looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. On to the next step. We're going to install the EAF bracket. This is going to go on here. These two little holes are going to be facing back towards the the camera end. And there's the hole right there, and the little lip is just going to seat right on there. And this is when we're going to need the 3mm hex head back out, and the third little screw here was, I didn't know what it went to. It goes to this. All right, there's the bracket for the focuser, and everything comes up So that's all the cradle system put together. This is the focuser ring. I didn't know what this part was at the beginning, but this is going to seat on the focus of the camera. And I think this requires a 2.5 millimeter. Yeah, it's a 2.5 millimeter to loosen this. And that's going to be the next step in this, is getting this ring on the lens and also getting the band on over the lens and inside the cradle. After reading the instructions, you have this little rubber focus band right here. What we're going to do is loosen this focus ring, and you're supposed to line it up at the very end like that. From the pictures, is what it looks like. So what I'll do is loosen this up and slide it over and make sure that it's lined up, you know, all the way around perfectly. So we got the 2.5 millimeter hex head, and they mentioned this already comes pre-installed in this ring, the little nut and the screw. So I'm just going to loosen it just a bit, and we're going to want the ring, the teeth going towards the front of the lens, and we're going to line it up with the end of this rubber right here. So we'll just go in this way like that. I'm going to make sure we've got this thing lined up best I can get it, and even with that rubber. So let's see here. I think that looks pretty good. I can see the lip. I think that looks pretty good. And I'm not going to tighten it, you know, crank it. I'm just going to get it snug in case we have to adjust it, but I don't want it sliding. So we'll just go ahead and tighten that down a little bit. The next step would be to just go ahead and open up the cradle. And we're going to put, put the band over the lens. It's not very stretchy. So you make sure that you put the teeth side down so it can grip this wheel right here. So now we've got that. Set it inside the cradle. The band is on. And when you set it in the cradle, and this is one thing I already see that I like about this particular, I'm gonna look at this, that's straight up on there. I'll spin it like this so you can see. But one thing I like about this cradle already is that it really does, I had a tough time adjusting the aperture, so I would just set it, and I'm usually setting it at F4. Once this is closed, you still have plenty of access to that aperture ring. So that's pretty cool. I didn't have that with that William Optics Red Cat holder. It was kind of covering this right here. So that's pretty cool. I like that already. And that really is looking pretty good, looking better than my old setup. So now that we've got the band and the teeth on right here, and it's inside the cradle, I'll go ahead and put these thumb screws in, make sure that's all lining up. And that little trick did work with holding the piece down and pushing it. When I tighten it down to the dovetail, that did make it flush. So you may have to do that. Now we're in the cradle, and I just want to see how easy it is to put this lens hood on. Perfect. Looking great. All we have left that came in the Astrodymium box is the the little wheel for the focuser. So I got the focuser here. I'm gonna go ahead and get it out. And this is my fourth one. I've got one more scope, and I originally bought this for that telescope, but when I saw this cradle kit and it came with the EAF adapter, I was like, well, let's just get one for this. So I picked this up a few months ago when it was on sale and got a few dollars off. So I don't think we'll need the brackets or any of that stuff. It's just going to go straight in here. We will need some screws, so I'll get those out. I guess we'll take the cables out as well. Probably use some of those. And we definitely won't need any of these adapters. I do have, ZWO does give you hex heads or Allen keys. So we'll just put this out of the way. And we're going to use this wheel on here. And in the instructions, which I've always backed mine off, I don't ever set it flush anyways because of the, I don't know if you can see this, there's a flat part right there and it doesn't go all the way down. So when you put the grub screws in, so I like to back it off a little bit. And they say to maybe use something like a credit card or a license or something. So I may try that to see how that does. I'm just gonna use these Allen keys that came with the focuser. So I know this one, this long skinny one fits the grub screws here. I'm gonna just back these out a little bit. And that doesn't go all the way in. And you don't want to have this thing seated all the way up against the metal. You want it to be out a little bit. So this is when we're going to use this card right here. I'm going to line that up with that flat part. I'm going to put a little quick guide down. And now let's make sure I have this lined up with the flat part. I'm going to go ahead and hold that and then tighten it. So I'll keep that guide right there and tighten this other one up. And it should be in place. This is going to have some tension on it. So I'm going to use the small end and get a little torque on this thing and make sure that's tight. And then make sure this one is tight. What I'm going to do before I tighten these screws on is I'm going to seat this in here. I'm going to see if that lines up. It does line up, but it looks like it could be a little bit more flush. I may have to come out with it a little bit, so I don't know if you can see that, but what you want to do is line that the teeth with the wheel on the teeth on the focus ring. So I am going to make some little adjustments here and then we'll come back. I could come out with the wheel just a little bit, so that's what I'll do, is adjust this. I'll just come back out just a little bit. I'll just add this right here for a little bit of thickness. All right. Let's see if I can. So that's got a little bit more space. I added a piece of paper and let's see how this looks. That looks better. That's lined up with the focus rings. I was going to adjust the focus ring, but it's lined up with the rubber piece. So I just, instead of doing all that, I just brought the wheel out a little bit more. It's going to work right there. All right. The next step is getting this band onto the focuser. If you need to, you can take these rails off or you can take the top rail off if that's all you have. But I was able to line this thing up on here And I haven't screwed this on yet, because if you screw it on, you can't twist it like that, and that'll bring this in. But the easiest way to do this is going to be just go ahead. You could come off of the focus ring. You can tilt that in to get it over the loop if you need to. But I'm going to push it in and get the band lined up on the focus ring on the teeth. So it would probably be a little easier if I took the rails off, but I think I've got it. So now I just want to make sure that this thing is, you know, pretty level. You know, you want it to be even. It's sitting flush. And they've got this, the two holes right here. You can slide this out if you need more tension. But that's pretty tight like it is, and that's sitting all the way to the left. So I'm just going to make sure that I've got a little tension on it when I tighten these up. That's the main thing, is I want to make sure that this is flush around the focus ring, which it is. And you know, I could take this top rail off and the side rail and get better access to it, but I can see through the holes here that it looks pretty flush on here. So the next step is I'm going to take this washer and this screw that came with the focuser, and I'm just going to go ahead and hand tighten that. All right. Now that's pretty tight. I think it's grabbing pretty good. Put a little bit of tension before I tighten it with the wrench. And the main thing I want to check is it's, you know, pretty level going around those teeth on that focus ring. And that does look, it looks good to me. You can see through there. There's a little bit of flex, but you probably don't want it too tight. But it doesn't feel like it's going anywhere. That's not going to slip or anything. So that's it. I did read in the instructions, you can say you want to adjust your rotation of your camera and your lens here. You're going to have to take this off and then adjust it, which that would kind of be a little tricky at night. But I think that's what I'll do. I would just take these two screws off and then just kind of tilt that like I did putting the belt on. And that should loosen it enough to where you can rotate the lens. All right, that's it. That's all installed. And now I just got to put the rest of this stuff on here real quick. So I'm trying to keep this video as short as possible. I'm just going to go over the final build out here and all the pieces I'm using. And I'm going to put links in the description for all this stuff. So we'll start at the bottom with I have the William Optics dovetail. This is the 245 millimeter. I think it's 9.6 inches. And I have that as the dovetail. And then, of course, we have the Astrodymium cradle holding the lens. And then I have the optional accessory rail for the ASIR Plus. And that's how we're going to be running everything. For the guide, I have the ZWO ASI 120 Mini and the ZWO 30 F4 Mini Scope. And the dew heaters, we have the Do Not Dew Heater Strips. In the description, I think it's the DN03 and maybe the DN04. I'll have to look that up just to make sure. But this is for like 2-inch eyepieces, and this is for 3-inch scopes. And that's not the measurements. That's just for in the description. But I'll try to find the correct links for those. And to attach the camera, I have the ZWO Canon EF with the filter drawer here. That's how I put my 2-inch filters in. We have the EAF installed. And the cable management is not very pretty. This is a really long cable that came with the focuser. I'll try to find a shorter one. I have that tied up with a rubber band, so it looks pretty funky. But it'll get the job done while I get all this stuff set up. And I'll just go over the connections real quick. I have the focuser plugged in to the back of the camera, USB 2.0, and I have the guide cable going into the back of the camera. And this is the ZWO ASI 2600 MC Pro. I have the, there's a 12 volt power cable, and I have that running into the 12 volt on the ASI Air. And I have the ZWO splitter. This works with these do not do heaters, and it only takes up one 12 volt port, and I can run both. I can run both do heaters off of this one port, and it usually does a pretty good job. That's it. That is the build out, and hopefully get a clear night here pretty soon to get this guide cam focused and get the focuser set up. And I was reading in the instructions, and I think they recommend to start with step settings from 25 to 50. Now, I have used a focuser on my Edge HD, and I just used the default settings. And what I did was I just wrote those numbers down. I didn't set any limits or anything like that. I didn't set anything for backlash, and it works fine. So I may just try setting this up without setting the backlash and the limits and stuff like that, and just use it, you know, with the default settings and see how it does. But yeah, this is it. Looking forward to trying this thing and seeing how it works, and I'll keep you posted in the future. All right, thanks for watching. Clear skies.